Most of us are pretty familiar with how stress can feel. Stress turns up the tone of your sympathetic nervous system relative to your parasympathetic. Over a period of seconds, your heart and respiratory rate rise. Sweat begins to drip from your forehead and underarms. The HPA axis releases cortisol, the body's main stress hormone. Cortisol influences specific areas of the brain, the amygdala, hippocampus, and prefrontal cortex, all areas that are heavily involved in cognitive processing. The human physiologic response to stress is often described as fight, flight, or freeze. At the macro level, it has evolved over the years to help us adapt to threats in our environment and ensure our survival. As a thought exercise, we can also examine this adaptation at the micro level, that is, how you adapt to individual situations. The maximal adaptability model shows where adaptation fits in. This framework is composed of three facets: input, adaptation, output. Input means the composition of the environment. Aspects like how tasks are organized, the speed at which information is presented, physical properties, and other contextual elements. While certain situations can generate a recognizable pattern of inputs representing a stress signature, each situation is completely unique in time and space. Adaptation encompasses the compensatory processes for dealing with the input. Processes include the cognitive appraisal assessment, evolutionary physiologic responses, and other psychological coping mechanisms. Nearly every person has compensatory processes, but not every person possesses all forms of compensation or can react in the same way to a particular input. Output depends on the explicit goals and cognitive state of an individual and is represented by how you behave in a situation. Output is your performance. Earlier, I showed you this inverted U-curve representing the relationship between stress and performance. Here, the middle is the sweet spot, and the curve is steep on either side. Since 1908, our understanding of stress has evolved beyond this curve. We now understand that individuals are able to adapt to environmental input, tolerating overload or underload without a substantial change in their performance capacity. If we consider the input-adaptation-output framework, we can improve on that original curve to produce an extended inverted U-curve. This curve demonstrates our comfort zone, lying between the maximal and minimal levels of stress. It also highlights the zones of psychological and physiologic adaptations to the changing stress level, mapping how people adapt and maintain a stable output in the face of increasing stress. Next, we'll look at the key effects acute stress can have on your abilities.